Okay, so you're turning 30, and I bet you're feeling old. I hear it every day in my clinic, and of course, I have to laugh. But yes, you're starting to see some signs of aging. That is what happens. And there's four essential things you want to maintain: your bone, your skin, your face fat pads, and your collagen slash elastin. I consider that one. Today, you get five exact steps from my protocol I use every day in my clinics. And yes, I will touch on preventive Botox at the end of the video, because the number one question I get asked, should I start Botox at 30? It's a top question, and I will address it. Now, some of you are watching this at age 50 or even 60 years old, but you're having the same skin, the attitude, the hormones, the metabolic rate of a 30-year-old. And so you know who you are, and yes, these top tips today do apply to you. It's all about aging rate. You have maintained and you're not catching up, like maybe the 50 or 60-year-old did, just showing up to the practice, not having done anything. That's a different case scenario. And I hate using chronological age. It's all about skin age. But for those around 30, you have this huge opportunity, and I'll spell it out exactly today. You never have to age like your predecessors have. Let's look here at where you're on this graph. You see, you're right here. You see, you still have it all, your collagen, elastin, hormones, the thickness of your skin. Now, how do you keep it? Remember, a few things are going to serve you well. Number one, prevention is better than any treatment, than any cure. You have the ability to prevent when you're 30. The other mantra you want to live by is less is more when it comes to wellness. Our medical system's failing. We know that. And the only one looking out for you is you. So how do you overcome it? You educate yourself by watching channels like mine and purposely get the products, the test, the examination you need. You need a little DIY here. The number one tip of your journey is consistent skincare routine. You want something that you will stick with, and consistency is key. First of all, you need cleansing. Now, your skin is about a pH of 4.7. So what you clean your skin with is very important. And most 30-year-olds I see in my practice now, they do get this. You want to use a gentle cleanser to remove the dirt and excess oils and impurities from your skin. You need that clean canvas to start with before your skincare. You want to avoid any harsh cleansers that are going to stop the skin's natural oils from doing their work and maintaining your skin barrier function. Now, don't over cleanse. I do see this so many people between 30 and 40, they're over cleansing. If you use a lot of makeup, and I know in your 30s, you're going out, you're partying, you're still living a great life, you wear some makeup, you want to think about double cleansing. And I have videos on that where you use an oil cleanser first to get rid of your makeup and then cleanse. I'm a big fan of that. But please remove your makeup after use, so every night typically. Next in this step is going to be moisturizing. You want to apply a moisturizer suitable for your skin type. And the goal here really is hydration, nourishing, antioxidants. Skin oils are your friend at this stage. Organic, cold-pressed seed oils. They're safe, they're effective, and I have whole videos on which one's best for you. And of course, skincare that you're using, that you purchase. You can use them together. You want to look for ingredients like hyaluronic acid, particularly with argireline. Ceramides are going to help maintain moisture and balance. And yes, you want to start a retinol here, preferably a retinaldehyde. Now, in your teens and 20s, nobody wants to hear this, but by 30, patients are all ears. It's called sun protection. You want to apply a broad spectrum sunscreen, at least SPF 30. Most people have gone to a 45 now because the 45s that we have do not leave white casts. They're well tolerated and they're not acneiform. So you don't necessarily have to deal with acne that we did with sunscreens in the past. So why a sunscreen? It's going to help prevent premature aging, sunburns, and reduce the risk of skin cancer. And I think, yes, I think we're overly scared about skin cancer. People are fearful of any amount of sun. Vitamin D is great. But even with a sunscreen, understand you're getting 50% of the sun's rays. And I know you like your tan, but by 30, I think most people realize the tan is killing your skin. We now have that. knowledge and the science to back that up. One thing that you realize now too, I know, your collagen, elastin, and machinery that builds the support and structure for your skin is on the downward slope. It's not like when you were 20 and it was still maintaining. So you make hyaluronic acid and you break it down continually. You make collagen and you break it down continually. At a younger age, you're making as much or more than you need. By 30, you're deficient, meaning the machinery to make it doesn't catch up with the amount we're breaking down. Sun, smoking, yes, you're going to need to throw your vapes away and your weed. Poor diet, lack of sleep, those are all going to increase what's called MMPs, matrix metalloprotein, and collagenases. That's what breaks down our collagen and what breaks down our given hyaluronic acid, our God-given hyaluronic acid that you have. Now, by 30, I know you all know about fillers and hyaluronic acid fillers because you're all getting lip fillers. Understood. But when I talk about here, I'm talking about your own hyaluronic acid. Okay. You have it in your body. Yes, you do. Everyone thinks that it's what we inject now because that's how you hear it, or we place it on the skin. But naturally, you have your own. And that machinery is breaking down. So don't accelerate it with those things like sun, like smoking, like pollutants, like poor diet, like poor sleep, alcohol as well. Now, you also have to consider exfoliation. This is absolutely key. Less is more, remember? So if you exfoliate, you're going to maintain your skin and you're not going to need Botox or fillers. So regular exfoliation helps remove dead skin cells and promote cell turnover. So your old cells aren't stuck down on the surface of your skin, giving a dull complexion. You want to choose gentle exfoliants at 30, such as chemical peels. Combination chemical peels are best. Scrubs with fine particles. I have many in my store. And many of you like microblading or shaving. It's accepted now. And yes, it works. Don't overdo it. By the way, before we go on to number two, remember, ask your mom when she entered menopause or the change of hormones. And I know this sounds crazy because you think I'm only 30, but what you don't want to miss here is premature menopause, and it's genetic. So that affects bone, fat pads, skin, and everything else. And if your mom says 36 to 40, you have to rechange your thinking, recalculate. But it's something you need to know because it plays a huge role in every system in your body. So just as an aside. Number two, we need to talk about supplements, what we call now nutraceuticals. These are proven. And if you eat a great diet and you have real food, no problem, you're getting it. However, most of us are not. And so the food supply is very different. You have xenoestrogens, plasticizers, plastic in our food, GMOs, and even the meat we eat doesn't contain things like vitamin K2 like it used to because the feed going to the animals does not contain real food. They're eating the same junk that humans are, and in turn, we're getting that junk and pesticides. So supplementation is key. Which ones? Well, number one is antioxidants. You want to increase your intake of antioxidants like what builds collagen? Vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin E, silica. Make sure you're getting bamboo shoot organic silica. I have that in my plasma restore vitamin, and you can get it from various ways. The second one's K2-D3. Now, we talked about premature menopause, but vitamin K is very important to put calcium into your bone. Facial bone keeps you young, and vitamin D3. For mine, I put 5,000 international units of vitamin D. That's the minimum most people should be taking. Vitamin D plays a role in many things, but also calcium absorption to maintain your bone. Remember I said the four things you got to keep. One of them was bone and, of course, fat pads and skin. Next, you need omega-3 fatty acids. A lot of people don't eat fish anymore. When you eat fish, you're eating farmed fish. But this is one of those supplements that every anti-aging guru on the planet takes if you ask them during a cocktail conversation. So if you're just sitting around with them after a show or after you go to one of their talks and they're just talking openly, they'll tell you they take this. Fish and other seafood, especially cold water, fatty fish such as salmon, mackerel, tuna, herring, and sardines. Now, mackerel, tuna, herring, and sardines, I rarely see anyone eat those, but they're so important. Other ways you can get it are, of course, nuts, seeds, flax seeds, chia seeds. So there are other options, but people rarely eat good fish. So include those foods and supplements. This is also the time you want to start a collagen supplement. Collagen, of course, that's what we're trying to keep. You saw that graph. Collagen's vital for skin elasticity and firmness. So you want to start a collagen supplement to support your collagen and the machinery that's making it. Now, I would be remiss if we didn't talk about sleep. You're 30, you're starting to hopefully come off the alcohol a little bit. Maybe it's only one or two club nights a week. So hopefully you're getting some sleep because it does make a huge difference. And I see it my patients every day. What are you aiming for? 7 to 8 hours of quality sleep every night. Quality. Sleep allows your body to repair, regenerate, and lead to healthier skin. I think this is one of those areas that it's only the tip of the iceberg as we're studying the mentation of people, memory loss, cognitive decline, and neurodegenerative diseases, which are taking over our older population. We're seeing that sleep plays a huge role, much more than we ever thought. A couple quick tips here. You want to create a sleep-friendly environment by ensuring you have a dark, quiet, comfortable room. This is one of the top mistakes I see in our 30-year-olds. Because you're used to just put your head down, you go to bed. Things are changing. The other thing is use breathable bedding to maintain optimal temperature. You want a little cool zone for sleeping. Oh, yes, the alcohol does affect your sleep and decreases your REM sleep. You need REM sleep to rejuvenate. Number four that's affecting our 30-year-olds like never before, and I think social media plays a big role, stress management. Chronic stress accelerates the aging process like no other. Yes, that includes your skin. Practice stress management techniques like meditation, deep breathing, engaging in hobbies. This is the time to start that. And the number one hobby for you is going to be exercise because that helps your sleep, decreases your stress all in one fell swoop. So when you think exercise, don't do anything where you're getting a lot of sun or environmental exposure. And you also want to limit your cardio to maybe 30 minutes, three times a week. But here's the key. You want weight training. We talked hormones already, and this is the age to think about hormone balance. Weight training and lifting weights and allowing your body to see stress helps your bone, but also as you build muscle mass, it helps your hormone maintenance. With sleep, I'm a melatonin fan. On this end of things, I do like ashwagandha and tonkat ali that are in my supplements for women's vitality and women's anti-stress vitamins. So know about tonkat ali and ashwagandha. Sometime between age 30 and 45, a lot of my patients take them and benefit. Now we're down to about number five here or so, and this is one of the most important, and that is a healthy diet. When I say healthy diet, what exactly do I mean? There's one thing here. Eat real food. Organic, real food. And I know it sounds simple, but most of us don't. You want to drink an adequate amount of water because water hydrates your skin and water helps filter with your liver and your kidneys. Most people are dehydrated now. That's how we live. People don't drink water and you need to. Proper hydration keeps the skin plump, of course, radiant, and reduces the appearance of fine lines and wrinkles. So that's what you see outwardly. Inwardly, it does much more. Now, some treatments you want to focus on. Before you get to Botox, chemical peels, combination chemical peels I talked about. Everyone's going to be different depending on your aging rate and your sun damage and your skin type. But in general, think two of these per year. I would avoid microdermabrasion unless it's to prep the skin for your treatment because microdermabrasion can cause vessels to come to the surface of the skin and you can get reds and superficial veins. So I'm not a huge fan of microderm. For the benefit you get, there are risks. A lot of you know RF microneedling. If you're going to do a treatment like that for face slimming or fat reduction in the face, okay, treat the lower face. If you're treating the upper face, you absolutely need an expert who does hundreds of these. You do not want to lose your face fat at this stage. So should you get Botox, you now hit 30, you're seeing fine lines and wrinkles. Botox does not prevent lines and wrinkles. It stops muscle movement, which in turn prevents it, but much more important is your collagen boosting, the things I talked about before this. If you're getting Botox, yes, it does work well for some eye lines, for the frown and the forehead. You will tolerate it well at your age. However, it will not prevent your skin from aging down the road. All it does is stop muscle movement. So you need to pay attention to the collagen building elements we talked about in the video and the treatments that we talked about to build collagen. You're getting it to stop some lines and wrinkles that you're seeing. That's totally fine. But if you depend on it solely and don't boost your collagen, you're going to be crying absolutely by 40 because a tiny bit of movement is going to create lines. Your skin doesn't have the support and the elasticity once you've lost collagen and elastin. So Botox does not build collagen or elastin. The other thing to keep in mind is that Botox, when you get it in your forehead, 100% of the time, your frontalis, not your glabella, but your forehead, 100% of the time, it lowers your eyes. It doesn't raise them. So what you're going to want to watch now is my video here on the one treatment you should not get with Botox, and I go through exactly what to do in your forehead to keep your eyes lifted. Stay tuned here. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.